Krishi Gyandeep knowledge series is basically a knowledge dissemination series where we invite one of the renowned faculty of the country to speak on the burning topic. The whole series, whole session has been recorded and has been disseminated to the various stakeholders like farmers and other stakeholders through, and we put the recorded session on our NIAM YouTube. I request Director General NIAM to welcome Shri Vineet Goenka and speak about, give introduction about the speaker.
Good afternoon to all of you and welcome back. This is the 7th Krishi Gyandeep series lecture. Previously, we completed around 6 lectures on very important topics like, you know, direct marketing, farmers producers organizations, then sustainability in agriculture, doubling farmers' income. So these are all some of the topics. So this is mechanism where the experts from different parts of the country, they come to NIAM, spend some time, share their lifetime experiences, for which our faculty friends, myself and all the students are the direct audience. But the objective never ends here. We are recording the entire talk, converting into a film, and this film will reach thousands of individuals and organizations across the country through ICT platforms. So taking knowledge to the doorstep of the stakeholder who is living in, geographically isolated situations is the very objective of this knowledge series lecture. So I would like to, heartfully welcome Mr. Vineet Goenka, and for this knowledge series lecture. Now, before the beginning, I would like to introduce the speaker. Mr. Vineet Goenka is a very fervent nationalist, technocrat, educationist, social activist, people's man. Now, even though he is from IT background, now he is working with, villagers and farmers. And visionary with a tenacious drive to inspire and bring about change within the society, having experience in the field of data sovereignty, information technology, infrastructure, transportation and logistics, HR, agriculture and public policy, over 2.5 decades of experience in various fields ranging from industry to politics to policy making. See, this is very, very interesting combination. You don't get with many people. A strong advocate of data sovereignty, why data is important and why we have to control the data, that he is going to talk in his Krishi Gyandeep Knowledge Series lecture. MSME sector and digital India are the focus, his focus, especially with indigenous technology. See, you underline this. We have the resources, only thing we have to make use of for promoting this concept. Now, has been a very avid blogger, writer in various mediums and speaker at various forums. Now, he is member of Governing Council, Center for Railway Information Systems, Ministry of Railways, Steering Committee member of Global Student Solar Ambassador Workshop, Secretary of Center for Knowledge Sovereignty, a think tank discussing on policies, former member IT Task Force, Ministries of Shipping, Road Transport and Highways. Everything is connected to agriculture. I think that is what we are looking now in his talk. And of course, various political forums of of national interest. Today, apart from delivering lecture, one of his important contribution, the recent book on data sovereignty, will also be launched. Of course, during his talk, he will talk about the larger content of the book. But I would like to introduce. this book before the audience. This data sovereignty book is, you know, special of its own kind. Now you may think actually why this topic is so important to agriculture. You know, agriculture is central for development of the nation. If data sovereignty is important for the nation, then it becomes important for agriculture also. Now when we are having mobile in every hand, probably these topics becomes very important directly, indirectly for everyone who holds a mobile in his hand. Now he talks about, you know, why important. I just want to sum up close because I think we have to have more time to listen to him. He talked about, you know, three things in the introduction of the charter. One is military colonialism. Now who is very strong in this world? You know, you have large number of soldiers, you wage a war and, you know, win the kingdom. Later became, you know, the animal horse, you know, over the horse and elephants, people can, you know, equipped with more ammunition, weapons, used to win the war. You have seen Bahubali picture, right? The people with, you know, animals, power and some techniques, they win the war. Then came the technology, you know, without, you know, soldiers using the technology, air force and, you know, navy, now people are winning the wars. Drones, satellites, we are talking about those kind of things. So the person who possesses military, he used to colonize others. Then came another concept called energy colonialism. So that is what he discussed later. Oil is very important. It is impacting the life of everyone. Let us think, you know, today the petrol or diesel is stopped for next 15 days. You can just imagine what is going to happen. So an impression is given in the recent days, whoever controls oil controls everything. But now, Vinit Goenka is talking about another concept. Whoever controls data controls everything. You agree with me? Yes. So nobody knows actually what is, you know, this technological giants in information technology are doing. Probably we will throw more intensive light on that. So whoever wins, data wins everyone. That is the theme of this data sovereignty book. With this introduction to the author and the book.
Well, let me once again, you know, thank you all for calling me here. The director saab, director general, directors of the institute, the faculty members, students, farmers, my wife, and also my friends, Virendra ji is here. So many people who are here. As I said in my earlier part, the 41st foundation day is very important because, you know, as you go forward, there will be many more foundation days which will be coming up. Let me first introduce to you the book and the authors. Did you get a chance to see the book? If you don't get a chance to see the book, what I would request to you to is go on social media and click data sovereignty. You will come to this. And 7 authors to this book, and there is 1 for writers, the person who wrote the foreword. And let me introduce each of them so that you know what I'm going to talk for the next 30-35 minutes. So in the book, when you see the book here, the gentleman who's on the left-hand side here is Lieutenant General Venkatesh M. Patil, also known as Venki, PVSM, AVSM. He was former Director General of Military Operation. Then you see this gentleman in the center. His name is Lieutenant General Dattatreya B. Shekatkar, also known as Shekatkar. He is famous because the recent committee on the defense came on his name. Then Lieutenant General Vinod Bhatia. Currently, he is Director of Joint Operations Warfare Studies. He is a special forces person, a very capable person. Fortunately, his son is also now commanding a unit in Special Forces. The person on the left-hand side corner is Lieutenant General Vinod Khandare. He was Director General, Defense Intelligence Agency. Right now, he is military advisor to the Prime Minister. And in the center, if you see the person with the white color hair, his name is Jaydev Ranade. How many of you know this film called as Ek Tha Tiger? So you were all excited. Everybody has seen it. So Ranade Saab was deputy director of RAW. So if the tiger was one agent of RAW, you can understand if somebody is deputy director of RAW. Bharat Panchal is from NPCI, he's director in NPCI, and this is myself. And the book got its foreword from none other, and I was very much blessed, sir, I could get the foreword from ISRO chairman, ISRO chairman, Dr. Kiran Kumar, Padma Shri Kiran Kumar ji. You know Kiran, I don't have to introduce Kiran Kumar, right? Mangalyaan and all this kind of thing. You would have seen him recently in that frame of TV when you saw that. And what are we talking about? Why is this the first time RAW military or NPCI and everybody has come together to write this particular book? So it's an interesting thing, and we thought we should talk to you on this. And I would like to thank Deepa ji for giving me this opportunity, and also the director sahab who gave me this opportunity here. In my childhood, sir, as I gave that example of New Zealand hostel, I have one more example where I read one line in Hindi and I never understood this. This is 1990s, 91 or 92. So I don't recollect between 90 to 93 because I was studying in college. My graduation is of 91, so it should be before 91. And there was two lines written in Hindi, Balashali Rashtra apni baat manwane mein shaksham hota hai. Can somebody explain this to me? Very simple two lines, Balashali Rashtra apni baat manwane mein shaksham hota hai. And I never understood this meaning. But then we heard a lot of about, you know, weapons of mass destruction. And then there was Iraq war in 91. Now it is 2019. Did you find a single weapon of mass destruction? So they identified, created a noise around this. And they bombarded simply. So Balashali Rashtra manvane mein shaksham hota hai. Because one country was powerful, it couldn't go and bombard other country. They said there is something wrong. And we all believed that particular part. This went on from 91, and as I progressed and I became a little older and senior, we were growing up, I was working. This is 2006 July. On 7th July 2006, Mumbai saw serial bomb blast. We had 7 or 8 blasts in the train. Do you recollect or have you heard about this? If you read this, you will learn this. And many people died. What was their crime? No crime. They were just traveling in the train, bomb blast happened. And after that, there was a discussion, there was some kind of deliberation going on, and that is the time when I heard KPS Gill speaking in that discussion. I was part of that discussion team, what to be done on the security side. So KPS Gill was there, Lieutenant General Shekhatkar was there, and Lieutenant General Shekhatkar talked about one shlok, and that shlok became our my life's motto, if I can say it is guiding me. And in this book also, when you see the first cover page inside, that shlok is written there. If I can pronounce it properly, my pronunciation may not be that accurate, but I hope you can understand the meaning. It talks about Ashvaneva, Gajaneva, Sihaneva Chaneva, Ajataputra Balidata, Devo Durbal Khataka. Have you understood this? So those who have not understood, let me tell you in Hindi. Ashvaneva, have you ever seen horse been sacrificed? Kabhi bhi aapne ghode ke bali dete hue suna hai? काम का है उसका, हॉर्स का बहुत काम होता है सर, वो यूजफुल एनिमल है. गजनेव, हाथी कभी कभी कोई बलि देता है क्या? मोटा है, कैसे काटेंगे, वो भी यूजफुल है, लकड़ी ढोता है. इट्स देर इज अ वैल्यू टू दैट एलिफेंट. सिंह नेव चनेव, कैन यू किल सम प्रीडेटर लाइक यू नो लायन टाइगर? शेर को कोई मार सकता है? वो तो खा जाएगा हमको, शक्तिशाली होता है. द लास्ट लाइन, एंड दैट विल टेल यू डॉक्टर यादव, it is so powerful. It says ajat putra bali data. Bali kiski di jati hai? Who is the sacrificial item? The sacrificial item or sacrificial commodity is ajat putra. Ajat is bakra, bakre ke beti ki bali di jati hai. And if you see the end of this shloka, it says devo durbal ghataka, even God dislikes who is weak and meek. Jo kamzor hoga usko to bhagwan bhi nahi bakhta. And probably because of that only Sikh Guru said we should be powerful, and probably that is the reason you see that chidiya nal baj ladawa. So he said even if we are sparrow, we'll fight with the eagle kind of thing. And that's the whole idea about this particular book, that we cannot be weak and meek so that people can sacrifice us. People should not sacrifice us. That was the whole idea. And what does it mean by sovereignty? And let me explain to you what is sovereignty. A simple fact. Can somebody explain me what is sovereignty? Samprudha kisko kehte hain? थोड़ा जोर से बोलना पड़ेगा. ये देखिए, आपके डीजी साहब ने बोला बड़े टैलेंटेड बच्चे हैं फर्स्ट ईयर सेकंड ईयर के. समबडी जस्ट गेट मैन से व्हाट इज सोवरेनिटी. संप्रभुता क्या होता है? संप्रभुता थोड़ा बोलना पड़ेगा. तो इफ आई पुट इट इन अ वेरी नॉन डिक्शनरी मीनिंग और अ नॉन लिंग्विस्टिक इंटरप्रिटेशन, इट इज अ वेरी सिंपल थिंग. जो खुद का निर्णय खुद लेने की क्षमता रहता है वो संप्रभुता कहलाती है कि हु कैन टेक इट्स ओन डिसीजंस राइट आई एम संप्रभुता आई एम ओनर ऑफ माई सेल्फ राइट इट्स अ सॉवरेन नेशन अब एक थोड़ा सा ना मुझे बताइए तो आई वॉज जस्ट थिंकिंग अमेरिका क्या सबसे ज्यादा तेल बनाता है ऑयल बनाता है क्या इज इट अ लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ द ऑयल डज अमेरिका कंज्यूम मैक्सिमम पेट्रोलियम इज अमेरिका हैविंग दैट मच ऑफ पॉपुलेशन विच वी हैव ऑयल बनाता है ईरान कंज्यूम करना है इंडिया को वॉट बिजनेस दे हैव टू टेल अस दैट की डोंट बाय इट फ्रॉम ईरान You have read this recently. Do you read newspaper? What business they have? We need oil. We consume oil. We have a population which is 1.3 billion. 130 crore logon ki jansankhya hai. Hamara zarurat hai. Hum khareedenge kisi se bhi. So if she gives me a better rate, I'll buy from her. If he gives me a better value, I'll buy from him. Who is that person? That is called a samprabhuta. Sovereign nation should take its own decisions. Are they influencing us? राइट एंड इफ यू डोंट बाय वी विल इंक्रीज योर टैरिफ्स है ना अगर बाय नहीं किया तो ये नहीं देंगे उनके यहाँ पे फिर सातवा बेड़ा भेजेंगे इज इट नॉट समथिंग विच इज नॉट सॉवरेन राइट इंटरफेरेंस है कि नहीं है ये सो इट इज अबाउट सॉवरेनिटी एंड डू वी ऑल लीव ओवर अवर सॉवरेनिटी व्हाई डिड अवर फोर फादर्स फाइट द वॉर ऑफ फ्रीडम दे फॉट इट बिकॉज दे वॉन्टेड टू हैव अ फ्रीडम राइट सॉवरेनिटी फर्स्ट फ्रीडम इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ सॉवरेनिटी राइट सो आई थॉट आई जस्ट टॉक टू यू अबाउट दिस DG Saab has already talked about energy decarbonization, which I just gave a small example of oil. But let us go back few thousand years back. What was the size of India? जोर से सही हमारा कुछ भाग अफगानिस्तान में भी था आज का पाकिस्तान है आज का बांग्लादेश है थोड़ा हमारा म्यांमार भी था हमारे पास बट राइट पर आज हम कितने हैं इज दिस राइट स्टेटमेंट हियर टू हियर व्हाट हैपेंड सो हमको थोड़ा सा चल के आना पड़ेगा वो और ये बात को अच्छा बिफोर आई टेल अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट आप में से कितने चाइना गए अच्छा कितने लोगों ने वॉल ऑफ चाइना के बारे में सुना है ग्रेट वॉल ऑफ चाइना कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द लेंथ ऑफ ग्रेट वॉल ऑफ चाइना 1100 5000 किसने बताया यू हैव गूगल किसी को एक सर्च करना तो सर्च कर सकते हैं 3200 माइल्स ओके सो 5000 किलोमीटर्स के करीब आता है दैट इज एंड व्हाई डिड दे मेक दिस वॉल व्हाट वाज द रीजन दे मेड दिस वॉल दे वांटेड टू प्रोटेक्ट देयर नेशन फ्रॉम द अटैक्स राइट And where did Alexander come to India? What was the place he came from? Sindh mein to har ke chale gaya wapas. Uski entry Hindustan mein kahan se hui thi? Hindu Kush. Hindu Kush kisne bataya? Exact. Hindu Kush to uska naam baad mein hua. When he killed the citizens there. Unka jab Kush banaya gaya. Unka chota chota jab tukda kiya gaya. So, उस लोकेलिटी के लोगों को वहां के रहने वाले हिंद के लोगों को जब उन्होंने टुकड़ा किया तो उसका नाम हिंद कुश हुआ लेकिन उस जगह जो है जहां से वो एंटर किया उसका नाम है खैबर पास है ना खैबर का जो दर्रा है वहां से उसका अंदर आया खैबर का दर्रा जो है इस तरह से है इट हैज गॉट अ वैली लाइक दिस एंड देर आर बिग माउंटेन्स जिसको अभी हम तोरा बोरा के माउंटेन्स भी बोलते हैं एंड विच इज ओनली विथ स्टोन्स बड़े बड़े पत्थर कुछ उगता नहीं है वहां पे ओपियम होता है कुछ होता नहीं है एंड द गैप इज ओनली 32 किलोमीटर्स अगर हम टॉप पे बैठे होते और हमने अगर इतना छोटा पत्थर उठाया होता था अगर हमारे बच्चे ने भी पत्थर उठाया होता था और आने वाले घुड़सवार के उन्होंने ऊपर से पत्थर मारा था 800 फीट ऊपर से गोलीवर वर्सेस गुद राइट हम कहीं पे भी मारेंगे तो लगेगा पत्थर तो क्या होता था उस घुड़सवार का मर जाता था और अगर हमने यहाँ पे 32 किलोमीटर का वॉल बना दिया होता था एक पत्थर वहीं पे थे चाइना में जहाँ पे दीवार बनाई वहाँ पे पत्थर नहीं है पत्थर दूर से लाए गए 50 किलोमीटर 60 किलोमीटर से लाए गए गुलाम हाथी घोड़े पत्थर लाते थे यहाँ पे तो पत्थर अवेलेबल था हमको सिर्फ ये भरना था धरना अगर हमने 32 किलोमीटर का दर्रा भर दिया होता तो क्या होता था वी वुड हैव मेड अ स्मॉल वॉल एंड टुडे इन 2019 आई वुड हैव ट्रैवल्ड टू पेशावर और टू रंगून विदाउट अ पासपोर्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड समबडी डिड नॉट टेक द डिसीजन दैट डे सम प्रोफेसर डिड नॉट टॉक अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ हैविंग अ वॉल दैट डे some student did not take it very seriously if it was discussed. There was some officer in the bureaucracy who did not do that in time. There was some officer in the military who did not understand the strategic value of making that kind of wall. Walls are never only physical walls. There can be also physical, virtual walls also, right? उस जनरेशन में शायद उनको उसका महत्वता पता नहीं चला. उसका परिणाम यह हुआ कि 2000 साल के बाद में आज हमारा भारत या जो भी भूखंड हम उसको बुलाना चाहेंगे, हिंदुस्तान बुलाना चाहेंगे, इज नॉट इवन 1/3 ऑफ द ओरिजिनल साइज. यू अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पैक्ट? वुड यू लाइक टू बिकम लाइक द चाइनीज स्ट्रैटेजिस्ट हु थॉट अबाउट पुटिंग दिस थिंग्स अराउंड हिम, और वुड यू लाइक टू बिकम अ स्ट्रैटेजिस्ट हु डिड नॉट पुट दैट थिंग अराउंड इट? व्हाट इज योर आंसर? यू वुड लाइक टू डू इट राइट प्रोएक्टिवली. वुड यू लाइक टू प्रोटेक्ट योर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन? Would you like to do that? It has to be a little louder. Sir, before I come on the topic, I have got 2-3 more things so that people, students can understand. I was a student and I used to get very much bored when teachers used to start from the chapters. Tab tak main wahan pe jata nahi tha, so I used to talk. How many of you have seen an ad of Colgate where it actually speaks, koile se daant kharab hota hai, koila ye hota hai? So maybe you students may not know, but DG sahab would know, madams would know, that in our childhood we used to see an ad ki koile se to kala hoga, safed thodi hoga, koila mein damage, it is not granular part, so black is bad, it has to be white teeth, and they would show you the teeth, white teeth. Now I see an ad, is paste ke andar koila hai, wahi company wahi paste ka brand hai, now it says koile mein hai ki nahi hai, paste ke andar koila hai. तब वो झूठ बोल रहे थे कि अब झूठ बोल रहे हैं? राइट, पहले झूठ बोल रहे हैं क्योंकि आज तो झूठ बोलेंगे नहीं, तो पहले झूठ क्यों बोल रहे थे वो? हैव यू एवर सीन दिस? प्लीज गो बैक, यू हैव स्मार्टफोन्स, डू सर्च दिस, विच इज दिस ब्रांड एंड डिड दिस गिव एन एडवर्टाइजमेंट 1980 to 1988, 8 years they were given एडवर्टाइजमेंट, कोयला काला होता है, दांत काले थोड़े करने हैं. हाँ, जो भी नाम होगा सर्च करना. एंड देन वॉट चेंज? तो उस समय पे ऐसा क्यों देते थे? तो सामने बिट्टू करके एक मंकी छाप, एक टूथ पाउडर आता था, बिटकोट मंकी छाप टूथ पाउडर. हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट दिस नेम? दंत मंजन आता था, यंगस्टर्स को तो प्रबल पता भी नहीं होगा. नासिक में देर इज अ फुल फ्लेज्ड प्लेस कॉल्ड एज बिटको बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. इट इज अ ह्यूज फैक्ट्री, अ मल्टीनेशनल कम्स इनसाइड, इट सेज कोयले से दांत काला होता है. हमारे लोग उसको बात को मानने लग जाते बिकॉज एडवर्टाइजमेंट विजिबिलिटी का इंपैक्ट है. हमने कोयले के साथ में उस काला दंत मंजन को रिलेट किया. वी स्टॉप्ड यूजिंग द काला दंत मंजन, वी वेंट टू अ व्हाइट मंजन, एंड नाउ आफ्टर 30 इयर्स द सेम व्हाइट मंजन कंपनी सेज कि कोयला भी होना चाहिए. सो व्हेन यू सी एन एडवर्टाइजमेंट, व्हेन यू सी एन विजिबिलिटी इंपैक्ट, व्हेन यू सी दिस, इट मे बी अ स्वैग, इट मे बी अ अटेम्प्ट टू मिसगाइड यू, प्रोबेबली टू टेल यू व्हाट टू बाय. एंड इजंट दिस अ कॉलोनाइजेशन? गुलाम बनाने के लिए केवल तलवार थोड़ी निकालना होता है. गुलाम तो आपको मानसिकता से भी बना सकते हैं, और हो सकता है कि मेरी पूरी पीढ़ी गुलाम बन गई, हमने हमारा ओरिजिनल टूथपेस्ट छोड़ दिया और वो टूथपेस्ट ले लिया, और दोनों का इंपैक्ट सेम था. सो प्रोबेबली वी शुड ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड कॉलोनाइजेशन डज नॉट मीन ओनली मिलिट्री कॉलोनाइजेशन. दे केम विथ कैनन, दे रूल्ड अस, देन दे केम विथ गन्स, दे रूल्ड अस, राइट? मोगल्स केम विथ कैनन्स, ब्रिटिशर्स, पोर्तुगीज, डच केम विथ guns to here. How many of you are from Gujarat? The person who is from Gujarat, have you gone to Gir forest? Or if you have gone to Jamnagar, there is a place where we also have, you know, we were colonized by even South Africans. The Siddhis were there. So we were colonized by Britishers, we were colonized by Portuguese, we were colonized by Dutch, Pondicherry was by French, we had the Siddhis. So are we so weak that we will be colonized by everybody? Any answer? So probably we were not thinking strategically. This is Rajasthan, sir. We have a huge production of rye, what do you call rye? Mustard. And primarily Rajasthan is to have a lot of mustard oil, which is kachi dhani tail also. But there is a channel called as Food Food Channel. And the chef who comes there tells that it is healthy to eat olive oil. And then he puts olive oil, thoda olive oil lena. And I and my wife always laugh when they say thoda lena, because wo thoda itna jyada hota hai, utna to hum ghar pe khate nahi, utna hota hai. And we have been told in the last 10, 15, 20 years that olive oil is better than any other oil. Do you have you ever seen the lab reports? Is it really good or it is not good? How many of you have seen it? But many of us who can afford that kind of costly oil, at least try to keep one bottle to show others. हमारे घर पे ऑयली ऑयल खाते हैं, खाते या नहीं खाते, लेकिन एक बोतल तो रख ही देते घर के अंदर कि दिखाएंगे. Isn't this that that somebody is colonizing your taste? Whether it is really good or bad can be debated. I don't know. Deepa is the right person. She is a food scientist. She can tell us कि सच में अच्छा है कि बुरा है. और वो सच में अच्छा मेरे लिए है कि सबके लिए है. But then we have been colonized. They have been giving us advertisement. They have been telling us repeatedly. They tell us all this kind of thing. And probably that is the reason we migrated from Suswa roti to pizza. How many of you come from Shekhawati region here or from Jaipur? So, thandi mein hum pata hai, wo bajra ka roti ko kaat ke beech mein se, then you keep it, put some little oil, put salt, pepper, onion and everything, and you just reheat it and get it. Isn't that similar to something pizza? But agar aapke ghar mein agar wo roti diya jayega, to you are seen as to be poor and backward. So, probably there is somebody who very conveniently is now not making you slave by putting a gun on your head. Somebody is very conveniently now is changing your mind and trying to make you a slave without telling you that you are a slave. You are understanding this gap? This difference? So probably that is one which we thought about talking about this particular part. What is the important statement? The important statement is God. How many people know God? God to sabko pata hoga na? Acha, koi student mujhe God ka full form bata sakta hai? So if you read CIA ka manual, they have definition of God. It is full form of God. And that's how CIA ruled the world all these 4-5 decades. I'm very careful, the cameras are on, but you can go do that. And now it is little changing. The God is changing. Earlier the God was one God and now it is becoming different God. What is God? G-O-D, God. So it was gold, oil and drugs. That were the currencies of international terrorism and or military currencies. Gold. You go to a dictator, buy him out, and then you establish your own colony. You have energy colonization, you have oil, you say you can't produce, you can't sell, you can't buy. And you dictate. And then there were drugs peddling which was done. Now this D is being changed, and now what is the D? Data. Any idea you have been colonized? Please tell me one example of that. Exactly. You use Google Maps? Do you pay them any penny? Then why are they giving you free of cost? Loudly, yeah, you're on the right side. Exactly, you're on the right track. Somebody else? He says the data is collected and they can manipulate us, right? Did we ever ask them, how do you know this road which comes to Niyam? And so perfectly. Who gave you a right to map this road? Have you ever asked this question to them? Rather, they tell you sometime, validate, right? And we validate. We are sitting in conference room. This place is the Director General's office. Do we update that? And we validate that question. They would ask you, please name the place. You would help them to name them, right? Are they collecting this information? What will be the benefit to them? Can they use this data against you? Can they market it to you? Have you ever thought why there are problems in particular states in India sometimes? So, sir, one example which happened. I'm coming on agriculture, but this is very tempting because you've got a very lovely student here. So everybody told us we should be green. We should not burn things so that there is no carbon emission. We should reduce cutting of trees. We should use less of coal. And I was with the railway committee. So the minister got excited and he said, why not do one thing? We migrate from carbon creating engines, locomotives, to a green locomotive. So we took a decision, we should not buy new diesel engines, but we should buy electrical engines. Was the decision right or wrong? Right, because diesel produces carbon. And the same people who was telling us, green emission, buy this machine, it will reduce this thing. The same people came back to us saying that you can't cancel the contract. Because their 500 machines, their 500 locomotives were bought. So that's the level. So ek taraf wo kahenge ki carbon kam karo, dusre taraf wo carbon banane wali machines ko bechenge. So there is somebody who's trying to play with your head. And see, when I go to agriculture college, I read about various Western scientists. Ford Foundation comes in, then you have Mensertos, you have got various people, and we get a lot of examples about the lab tests which have been done in the Western country. sir will be the right person, madam will be the right person to tell me. PUSA also does a lot of experiments. ICRA does a lot of experiments, and we have got best of the scientists sitting here. Deepa is one of the scientists who is sitting here. But lab to land is a big challenge. Whatever has been invented in these labs, many times we see that it is limited to that lab, right? It never goes out. Who is the hindrance? Have you ever thought about this? This is to be discussed by the directors here. This cannot be discussed by the student. When we have got best of the scientists, which is the documented first book on agriculture? Anybody can tell me? Students? Jor se bolna padega. I can't hear because I'm on the stage.
Book on agriculture was Horse Sowing Husbandry by Jethro Tull.
Jethro? Okay, lovely. Anywhere else you have got mention of agriculture? Okay, how many of you had heard about Raja Janak plugging and Sita coming out of the soil? Have you heard about this? Sita Maya ka janam kaha hua tha? Zameen se. Aur kya kar rahe the Raja Janak us samay pe? Football khel rahe the. Ball maarte gaye to dekha ek muh hai wahan pe. He was doing plugging, right? He was plowing na? Khet mein hal jot rahe the. So did we have a technology of plugging the land? Agar technology nahi hota, methodology nahi hota, tools nahi hote to kaise karta tha na? Okay, Balram was carrying what? Hal. So hal to hoga na? So hal ka kya karega? Sir, yuddha ladne ke liye ki hal was prepped. What did it mean? It mean that if one brother is king and is fighting with Sudarshan Chakra, other brother, 50% of the brothers have to be farmer with technology. So probably that hal was a resemblance of using tools. Have you thought about this? And my dear sir, the book, first book, I don't know about the first book, but the first scientist who wrote the first book, if I am right, the name was Rishi Parasar. He defined the agricultural methodologies, right? Did you hear this, Rishi Parasar? How many of you know Rishi Parasar, Maharishi Parasar, sir? Don't worry, even I never knew this. When I was coming here, so I said, kuch to points nikalna hai. So I also learned this. So you are not challenged. We all are a challenge. Somebody decided we should not know Rishi Parasar. Somebody decided we should not know that Balram was carrying tools. Somebody, you know, very conveniently told us that was one incident where Sita was born. It is not an incident. This is primary to tell you the importance that even the king has to pluck the land. Well, why were we called as Jagatguru? Any idea? Were we called as Jagatguru just because we were giving lectures? So let me take you back a few thousand years back. Human beings would either kill and eat or plug and eat. Peru toda, amrut bolte hain yahan pe na, amrut toda kha liya, ho gaya. But the hunger was not controlled. If there is a famine, what do you do? Agar sukha pada to kya karenge? Kuch khane ke liye nahi. Agar baad aaya to kya khayenge? There was nothing for tomorrow. And I think probably in this particular land, we were the first people who identified how to grow cereals, grains, process it and store it. Chawal ugana kaise? Usko process, chawal aise kacha kha sakte kya aap? Usko process karna padta hai, fir usko store karte, right? So how to grow it, store it and then how to cook it. Can we just eat the rice, kacha rice kha sakte hai kya? Ubalna padta hai na? Jyada ubala to kya hoga? Gal jayega kam ubala to? Kacha rahega. So somebody knew how to grow it, how to process it, how to store it, and then how to cook it. That methodology and technology which was developed here, probably we were not writing it. Or maybe it was written, we have not read it. And so we forgot that we were the people who overcame the problem of hunger. The documentation was not proper. Have you heard about jaggery? Gud kitne logon ne suna hai? Gud kaun se pet ko lagta hai, madam? Sugar cane ko lagta hai kya? Sir, aapke students kehte hain good sugar cane ke ped ko lagta hai. Good is, how do you take out good? To harvest sugar cane, squeeze it, collect it, then heat it at one temperature, right? If you overheat, what will happen? It will burn. If you heat it less, what will happen? It will be sluggy. So there is a right temperature, there is a lab condition, right? And then you get a... Have you heard about, you know, Ganesh ji eating modak? How is modak made? What are the three ingredients of modak? People from Maharashtra can easily say. It is rice flour, jaggery, and coconut. And what is coconut? It is not outside. You take the coconut, you should know how to break it, then there is a technology which or a technique to remove this part. If you know this, we were the people who actually made this food. And that's why we were called a Jagatguru, because we could overcome the hunger. Sir, we would make food and keep it for days. When you can keep it for days, then you overcome the hunger. Somebody deliberately, very deliberately did this. He told us not to do it. We did not document it. We just believe that there are books which are coming out, and probably that is true. Somebody very deliberately is the same way collecting our data which will go outside India. Why it is going outside of India, we don't know. Who is collecting it, we don't know. Have you ever thought that agriculture mein space ka koi utilization hoga? How many of you think about this? What is the use of agriculture, space in agriculture? One is remote sensing, second. Profile mapping. You know what is this technology called is? Okay, what is full form GIS? So put it very short, it is geospatial technology. Have you ever checked with them, how come they know our roads, they know our soil mappings, and do we have our own database? I don't know whether it is there or not, I don't have an access, but it's not very easily available to us, right? So somebody went on collecting the data. There is a lake here, there is a water canal next to it. Somebody knows your what, where is the water, where there is a soil, where there is minerals. And can they play with us? Is it possible? How can they play? So let me give you one example. With the help of ICT, information technology and communication technology, can we know where is the land? Can we identify the exact location where there is a water in the farm? And we can drill the hole there to get water? Will it be better than the drilling holes at anywhere and everywhere? So, will you know the speed of the air which is coming? Can we have a historical data about speed of air? On 8th August 2019, this is the speed of air. Can we also have the speed of air of 8th August 2018? 17 like this? The meteorological department may have data of more than 100 years. So can we predict what will be the speed of air? Right? We can predict that, right? Will it help in the farming? I was talking to DG Saab. Many times, you know, the farmer is spraying pesticide and does exactly ulta where he's not supposed to stand. He stands there. He consumes this pesticide. Will it have impact on his health? Many times you spray on your farm, but your neighbor gets benefited. Right? Can this technology tell our farmer what is the benefits? Do we tell them? We may tell them, we may not tell them, right? But they have the data. Do we have a market access data? So we have been discussing, have you heard about APMC? How many APMCs are there in India? See, you're in marketing, you should know how many APMC. So here starts my deliberation on your lecture. Somebody has to have this data there, right? How many APMC? Does APMC take data? Do they know what has been sold? Can I identify what has been sold in Kershong in 1966? APMC Kershong has that data, right? Can I come out that APMC Kershong was to sell oranges and then it went up? And somewhere in 2004, the sell went down. Can I make this kind of historical analytical data and can predict what will be the sell next year? And what is the reason of this? In the same period, I see that in the Kershong APMC, this data is not available, why it went down? But on the other side, do we have farmer cooperative called as, you know, Darjeeling Tea Cooperative Society? And they have a data that how they have been growing. So if you see these two data, then you will realize that the farmers migrated from orange production to tea production. Can we have a correlation done? But are these databases at the same places? Does every village have a PDS shop? Very nice example given by your director general for the midday meal. Khana ye banate hain, wo upar wale leke jate hain, fir wo central warehousing corporation mein jata hai, then it comes back to district officer, and then it comes back to the same village. Ugane wala hi fir se khata hai. But then the price goes plus, 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 plus and comes back. Do we have PDS system? Can PDS give us a data, what has been consumed there in that area? Do we have any more databases which can be created? Do we have KVKs in this country? How many KVKs? 617 KVKs, right? Which are functional right now. 197 has been sanctioned. Does KVK have the data about what is their farming community? How many people are there? I was very excited when I heard you had people who have passed through this land. 1,05,848 people passed through this, right? Do you have a database of their telephone numbers? Do you have a database of your emails of these people? Do you have a database of their addresses? And just think, your director general is going to a place in Assam called as Dibrugarh. And we can pinpointedly send a message. DG name is in Dibrugarh. People around them can contact. And four students come and they contact you. Will you be happy or not? There will be some business which will be attractive. So when I was coming to Jaipur, my team just blasted one WhatsApp and SMS. Vineet Goenka in Jaipur. Instantly, I have got two friends. One of my nephew came here, met me. You saw the boy who was here? Young boy, I did. So he's actually a third year engineering student. He's my nephew. So he has exam. He can't come to meet me. I have my own work. I can't come. So we said there is a place which is nearby. We met for 5 minutes. Happiness exchange program. We have database of 1,05,000 people. KVKs have database of all the students who have passed from there. They have database of the farmers. We have APMC which have got database of what has been produced. We have got agricultural officer who have database of what has been grown there. Do we have insurance database? What is the claim? Can we have that insurance database? An insurance database will have the reasons of failure. What is insurance? Insurance is a documentation of failure, right? Whether it was failure because of famine, because it was storm or earthquakes. Can we connect all these databases? Is it possible? Cut the story short, do we have national sample survey? Talks about many things, right? Do we have national agricultural survey? Do we have a data related famine? Hum sunte na 22 saal se famine gir raha hai yahan pe, 22 saal se sukha pad raha hai. What is the power of data? The power of data is, if a capable person like P. Chandrasekhar ji, your director general, becomes head of this project, and I'm sure, sir, I'll keep this to the people whom I can keep. Because I have very rarely seen a person of your vibrancy. But if we can just collate this data, the meteorological data, what is the wind, light, lumex, heat, right? Sir, suraj humko kya deta hai? Prakash deta aur taap deta hai na? It gives us lumex and heat, right? Two things, this. Wind gives us what? Wind gives us oxygen as well as it gives us a opportunity to pollinize our thing. Pollinization happens because of wind, right? One, and it also helps in other many other things. Soil, can we check the soil? What is the nutrition level of the soil? Whether the soil has got... Can we also check the water? While we check the NKP of the soil, we can also check what is the hardness or PHP or level of water. Can we do that? Our labs are good labs. Sir, I had an opportunity to go to Kundewadi. Kundewadi is next to Nasik. Somebody is from Nasik Chetra. Somebody said he was from Nasik. Which place? Yeah. Have you gone to Kundewadi? Sir, you will be surprised to know. Kundewadi Wheat Research Organization is 1905. Formed in 1905. They came out with a strain of wheat. And now that wheat is the primary seed for maximum weed correction. Now, wheat is grown in Punjab, but the research is done in Nasik. Can we connect the wheat farmer with them? Possible? So, we have these databases. We have the ability to connect. Can we create something called as National Strategic Room? Agricultural strategic board where we can have all the historical data, all the analytical data which comes together, and we forecast what has to be grown. Can we force our agriculture officer to give seeds under national programs? Can we train our students to use the methodology in the KVK? Answer is yes. Do we have a successful case study? Have you heard about Amul? Do they have cow? Right? They don't have cow, right? But are they largest community of cow? Can we create this kind of community under agriculture and say, hey, enough of importing of our food grains. Is it possible? For this, who will need the database? We have to create the database, right? Sir, I don't know how much time I have, but I have 2-3 important points. Let me complete this. Before I speak, let me tell you, I don't know whether it is right or wrong. Whether my assumption is right or wrong, so there is a caveat emptor. Let the buyer be aware. Have you heard about a pesticide called as endosulfan? It is good or bad? Who all believe it is bad? Raise your hands. So those who don't raise their hands, will say that it is good, right? Now, where was this endosulfan invented? So you may not realize it, but probably Professor Saab will realize, sir, hamare dadaji hai na, ek heat late the. There used to be a pump like this, right? He used to put one, uske upar he used to put more kerosene, right? And then pump it. Kya kya mar jate the usse? Machhar, makhi mar jati thi, tilchatte, yani cockroach mar jata tha. Wo jo moth hote light ke wajah, wo mar jate the. Lizard bhi bhag jati thi. Ek se sab kuch nikalta tha. Abhi kya karte hum? Kala heat, मच्छर मारने के लिए, लाल हिट कॉकरोच मारने के लिए. तो छिपकली को मारने के लिए क्या है? कोई हिट आता है मौत को मारने के लिए? अगर फार्मर इतना इंटेलिजेंट होता, इतना पढ़ा लिखा होता कि उसको 66 केमिकल्स बाहट होते, तो गरीबी से कुछ जूझता? सो व्हेन दिस वेस्टर्न पावर्स केम टुगेदर टू एडवोकेट दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट, आई रियली डोंट नो, आई डोंट हैव एक्सेस टू दी Madan Gopal Varshney committee report, whether endosulfan is really bad or good. Maybe one of your researchers can go back and see. It is banned now, right? So, reasons. Then you see, you know, there are photographs of people who have got dissing. We have to ask one question. If it is so bad, what was that? Why was that molecule introduced to us? Did you ask this question to yourself? Who introduced that molecule to us? And when was this molecule been declared as to be not good for humanity? So I agree with the people who have researched and they said that the molecule is not good for human consumption or human dosing. Sir, but basically I understand it gets disintegrated. Its half-life is only 15 days. It's a sulfuric powder which sticks outside the fruit. It does not penetrate the plant system. So when you wash it, it goes. Disintegration is 15 days. So it does not come into my part. But there are pesticides when you inject, it goes into the plant life cycle. And through that, it comes into human body. So they may be more challenging. 45 years, Westerners made this chemical. When they exported to everyone, nobody talked that it is a bad thing. They only just to put one warning, red color warning. If you remember, there's a warning, not good for human consumption, keep away from children, blah, blah, blah. The day India started making 90% of endosulfan, XL Care Crop, Koramangala, Hindustan Pesticide Limited. That is the day when world started talking about impact of this molecule. So, jab tak hum zeher bana ke aapke pilayenge, tab tak to koi problem nahi hai. Lekin jab aap hamara dhanda band kar denge, tab humko batayenge ki zeher hai. Are you getting it? See, you are students. I have lived my half life. I only have more half life to live. You have full life to live. Two questions I never understood, and I was standing there in the courtroom and I was waiting that CGI will speak something on this, sir. I was waiting that all the agriculture experts will tell why were they using this if it was a bad thing. And when did it become bad? When they identified that it is bad, or it became bad when they were not able to sell that chemical, it was bad. And in India, a smallest farmer who has got 2 bigha, he also has a kitchen garden, right? Tomato ke kide tomato khate hain, mirchi ke kide mirchi khate hain, aur kadi patta ke kide kade patte khate hain, wapas mein jate nahi. So we have a multiplicity and complexity of the pest which is there in that farm. We cannot have a narrow based pesticide. We need a broad based pesticide which will kill it. And whether it is bad or good, I am not debating into that. I don't have scientific data, so I don't want to get into this. But where is the broad based molecule which will kill the pesticide? And today our cost of procuring pesticide has gone up phenomenally. Unfortunately, we don't have a single indigenous factory. We don't have a molecule of our own. So we import licenses, we import molecules. So I don't want to get into the debate whether endosulfan is good or bad, sir. But one question comes to me. Why were they giving poisons to my dad and my grandfather and my great-grandfather? And number two, why am I paying thousands of crore rupees of foreign exchange to get this molecule? Are my labs not competent? So the answer is, somebody slaved me.
somebody very nicely colonized me. They had a data. How many farmers are multiple grain or multiple farmers here? And they knew how many will buy this molecule. So they made that kala dant mandin achha nahi, safed dant mandin achha hai. And when the market was open, then they said koila bhi achha hai. See, now you understand why did I give you example of Colgate? I don't want to shy out. Even if they want to file a case against me, I don't have any problem. So one company said don't use black, and now they are saying use black. One company said don't use endosulfan, now they are saying don't use endosulfan. In within 30 years, our own lifespan. And we don't challenge them. One country says there is a weapon of mass destruction, and then they don't find a single weapon of mass destruction. One country does not produce oil, but say don't buy oil from this country. Don't you see there is a slavery, colonization in this? How many does agree with me? You know, there is very big, a famous foundation which goes to farmer and help them. And they say, we will identify problems of farmer. We will give the report to the government, and government can then take action on that. Is this foundation helping us? So, okay. Do they help us? They help us because they collect data. Then tell us, this is the problem. And then government can work on their recommendations, right? Policy advocacy is one of the part of NAMS, right? So data is used for policy recommendation. But have you thought that all this data which is collected, do they share this with NAMS? Do they share it with your KV case? Do they share it with your own planning commissioner, now Niti Aayog? They give you recommendation. So they will say, Jhunjhun district ke Nawalgarh tehsil mein Jhajad karke jo gaon hai, usme ye samasya aur uska ye recommendation hai. But how did you come to that recommendation? Do they tell you the methodology of finding the solution? Boys and girls, when you grow up and come to my age and when you stand here, many times these solutions are not the solutions which are genuine, right? Many times the solutions are market-driven solutions. Is it true or false? Somebody is trying to tell you what to eat. Just tell me, when you put your photographs on social media, are you secured? So you're not secured. Is there somebody deliberately trying to tell you what to do? So let me come on this book. When we're writing of this book, what happened in small, small things? We use social media. I was sharing one incident with your director general. There is this farmer there in Mukundgarh or somewhere in Jhunjhunu. Uneducated, 66 years old man, but he has a mobile. So he goes to the plant, he sees some paste on the leaf. He clicks it and sends it to the agricultural officer. Likhne nahi aata, to kuch likha nahi hai. Agricultural officer is happy. Ki pasine mein latpat, matti wala, koi farmer mere darwaje mein aake mera carpet kharab nahi karega. He gets it. He sees that pata hai ki tau cannot read anything. So he goes, takes the pesticide, clicks it and writes 1:30 back. This farmer goes to the Krishi Seva Kendra, which is there, the farmer's cooperative society, and shows him that okay, this is what I want. The officer who is there, the person who is selling it, does not understand the number or the degree. So he calls up the agriculture officer, sir, apne photo to bheja tha, lekin kaun sa wala, 50 degree wala bhejna. And you know, this happened. Can we have this kind of power of communication, where the farmer does not have to travel for 40 kilometers, 50 kilometers? Can we have a small WhatsApp group, where if one farmer gives us a problem, and the solution is given by the agriculture officer, scientist or professor, can everybody benefit out of that group without sending good mornings and good evenings? Right? Can we do this? But at the same time, is somebody collecting the data from you? Is it possible? Give me two examples and I'll stop it. So let me give you one example. Very unfortunate example. Sir, there was a girl whose father saw a photograph of the girl in a not a very good this thing with a boy. Natural reaction of the father was he slapped the girl. He felt very this thing. The girl was very honest and went and told the father, one, I never did this activity with anybody. Two, I don't know this man. I have never seen this man in my life. Both are incorrect. Generally, father knows the daughter, right? He believed, also disbelieved. So they went to police station. The police guy, first habit is to say that, no, no, your daughter has done this. क्या बात कर रही है, झूठ बोल रही है. There was an insult to the girl again. But the policeman also believed when the father said, कि नहीं आप सुनिए, and he also believed that girl. So he wrote an application to this service provider, the social media service provider, that we have seen this photograph which is there. We want to know from which IP it has come. We'll believe that the social media app said we don't provide IP addresses. Right? They don't have a rule of sharing their data. So they said we don't provide IP addresses. And all this does not happen in one day. It was taking days. Now there is an insult to this girl. Another photograph came. It is very embarrassing. When father is angry, sometimes hum jab gusse mein hote to bina buddhi ke bhi kuch bol dete bachcho ko, to hum bol dete hain bina intention. He hit it. Maybe he would have thrashed that girl or something like that. The girl felt very humiliated, sir. And what unfortunate was to happen, happened. The girl did suicide. When the girl did suicide, it became a case of 302. It's an international understanding which we have. So naturally, the police officer was also very concerned why this company is not giving IP address. So they went to the MEA and MHA and got a protocol been evoked. Then naturally, a notice was sent under international understanding. Now the service provided the IP address. When the IP address went, the local police went, searched that particular place. They caught hold of one boy who would have sent it. And they reached another boy who had done that activity. And what is the story? And please listen to this very carefully. This can happen with you, me. It can happen with our children also. So there was an auto rickshaw driver who was standing below the house. This girl is to go to college sitting in the auto rickshaw. You never see the face of the auto rickshaw driver, right? Bhaiya chalo. And the auto rickshaw driver started liking this girl. Very innocent boy. Every person can like another person, right? There is no class barrier. There is no monetary consideration, but it can happen. This boy shared it with his friend. The friend said, "Tum to auto rickshaw driver ho, gareeb ho, tumko ye bade aadmi ke bachche kyun milegi? Ek kaam kar, usko badnaam kar dete, tumhari shaadi ho jayegi." A stupid thought, unthoughtful thought. So they just fudged, what is it called, as morphing, na? They morphed the photograph of the girl and sent it to her father. Ki badnaam ho jayegi, to baap ke paas koi option rahega? Kisi gareeb se shaadi kar denge, humse shaadi kar denge. A stupid act. Why am I telling this to you here right now? On your lecture? Any guess? Louder? Little louder, gentlemen. You are future of this country, right? The voice of... See, the father believed the girl, but he had a doubt. The police officer had a doubt on the girl, but also he believed it. Did the police officer request for the IP address? He had requested for the IP address, right? The service provider said, no, we will not give it address because not been under that mandate. When the death happened, then the mandate came. Had the IP address been provided in the time, we could have saved the girl. This boy would have been caught. And what is the punishment for stupidity? Do char thappad laga tha police officer, maafi mangwa deta. Aur jo provision hoga for ka, jo bhi 6-7 mahina, 3 parivar bach jate the. Us bachchi ka death nahi hota, ye rickshaw wala bach jata, uska jo advisor tha, wo bach jata tha. They could have just got some small nominal punishment under the provisions of law. And somebody denied the IP address. What happened? They lived under embarrassment till their actual culprits were caught. The rickshawala is behind the bars for abetment of suicide. His friend is also behind the bar, right? 3 families. They control data. And they also control your life, whether you will be happy or you will not be happy, whether you will do suicide. They didn't share the data in the time, and the resultant is same incidents, same act of sharing, just denied. And why did they deny? That arrogance which is there. That arrogance has to be challenged. We are a country of 1.3 billion people. How can they deny us that? And it was for our legitimate right? That is because they are controlling data. This is a true story. Please search this story. Today that girl is there. Tomorrow it can be somebody from my family, right? It can be you also, right? And what right they have not to give this data? So my friends, if you see from not knowing what Rishi Parashara did, not even understanding the importance of Raja Janak, not even realizing that we had great scientists who could create our own localized. If you go to research organizations of Kundewadi, you go to research organizations of grapes, we have tea research organizations, many research organizations. We've got fantastic innovations and discoveries been done here. We don't do a lab to land case.
when we don't do lab to land case, we land up buying things which are there in most Western this thing. It is not wrong to buy Western things, but it is wrong to follow it blindly. Somebody has to come and tell me why endosulfan was banned. If it was banned for rightful reason, then why it was to tell black toothpaste was banned or not been used and why it is now good. Friends, I would like to give this thank your Director General for giving me an opportunity to talk to you. Thank Dr. Deepa for introducing both of us. And thank you everybody who is there. Don't go back happy from this room. Don't go back saying that we have learned. Go back from here unhappy, agitated. Go back from this room saying that what all have to unlearn it. Think why the he is giving you free services. Ask that person, why are you giving me this free service of WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn? Why these maps are free? This data is not within my country. Ask the government, if you are spending 10,000 crore rupees on CDAC, you have heard about CDAC, CDAC? They have done a great job. They made a supercomputer in 1997. They got Padma Shri. And what is the speed of the supercomputer? You have mobiles with 4G connection? Deep, jara apna upper phone kariye. This is now has more capacity than that machine. And from 1998 till date, sir, no innovations. CDOT, CDOT, has got a very lovely app called as Samvad. Please visit Delhi to their facility. Meet Dr. Vibhagi. Great human being, great scientist. Can be compared with WhatsApp. Who are the people who are not allowing Samvad to come in the diaspora? And we have WhatsApp. We have got a lovely NIC, which has got solid capacity of data centers. Why are we forced to have cloud? Why are we forced to buy new data centers? Why is our data going outside? Can we all collate this? Ask these questions. Go back. Ask this question to yourself. Ask this question to your professors. Ask this question to the government authorities who are doing it. I would like to remind you what I started from. Let's make that 32 kilometers of wall, right? Or you will have Hindu Kush. We'll have people who will break your country, who will break your society, who will break your methodologies, who will break your way of living. Thank you very much.